So we have Manaswini Das from Red Hat, and she will be talking about open source opportunities and how you can make the most of open source, how to get started. And she also leads the PyLadies Bhubaneswar chapter. So I think we go way back, and I've seen her journey, and it's pretty inspirational. So I think all of you would also get enlightened by her talk. So Manaswini, all the best.
Thank you. That's very humble of you. Thanks for the introduction. So cool. We are definitely on time.
Yes.
So yeah, let's get started. So first of all, I would like to say why I'm going to speak about this, because I've been in your place since as a student, and I have explored open source, and I have, you know, literally made a career out of it. So I totally understand your difficulties, your problems, and this endless loop of opportunities and endless loop of experience and, you know, making the most out of it. So it's like, you know, if you need experience, you need internship. And if you need internship, you need experience. So there's this endless vicious cycle. I have also been through it. And let me tell you, I have never been on an in-office internship yet. So yeah, so I thought that I should try and help you guys, the ones who are finding their way in open source, and you know, trying to make a career out of it. So some of this may be redundant because Muskan Khedia, the experience sharing session that she gave yesterday, had some things already covered. So just bear with me, and it is mostly for beginners, but. If as an intermediate developer, you can also learn something or the other. So we are here to share knowledge. So feel free to shoot your questions, and I'll be here to take this up from the chat channel. So cool. First of all, I would like to say why I'm accountable for talking about this, because I have been an outreach intern, and I have worked as a fellow under the Pressing Foundation. And I have also mentored with Google Coden, GirlScript Summer of Code, Mentors Without Borders, and Red Hat Open Source Contest. So I have been on both sides of the table as a mentor and as a mentee. So I know what it takes to be a part of an open source program. So yeah. And also, I am an associate software engineer at Red Hat, so which is basically an open source company. So yeah, moving on. So what is open source? So feel free to share your answers about what open source is for you, and what you understand by the term open source. So I think we will be running out of time if I'll be waiting for questions. So first of waiting for answers. So first, I would like to say that it is some code which is open, which can be redistributed and, you know, modified in such a way so that it can be better, and it can be made in such a way such that you can share it with some license and, of course, some other intellectual property rights constraints. But yeah, you can always, you know, make it better, use it, and it's freely accessible and available everywhere. So yeah, moving on. So why did I, you know, try to venture into open source? So the first reason is, of course, it's free and accessible, and it always attracts like-minded people. So I'm very sure that you guys must be really curious to have mustered the courage to attend PyCon India. So I was like you at one point, and I also started attending PyCon India in 2018, and it really inspired me to venture deeper into open source. So that's where I met Niharika, that's where I met other PyLadies people, and I have and it's been a great journey. And I think you know, if you choose this, you'll definitely you know, get a lot. So next thing is exercise control over code that you like or don't. Of course, that is, you get to know the industry best practices. You get to work with, you know, developers from all over the globe, and you can understand what it takes to maintain and to, you know, update a project. So next is rapidly changing for the better. Of course, since there are a lot of people working on a particular thing, so we can always come up with new features and what can be better. And Yeah, so it is rapidly changing for the better, and being a part of it makes you at par with what the world is, you know, doing with softwares and, you know, normal development at large. So, and the next thing is, of course, doing all this will help you build a portfolio and help you build a strong, you can say, a strong profile for whatever you're looking for. If you're looking for looking to enter into hardware development, software development, ML, AI, anything, open source has you covered. So the next thing is, of course, it's fun. I've been here for like contributing to open source for 3 years, and I think that it's great. And so, yeah, I'm having a lot of fun here. So I would surely like to share the fun with you. Okay, so this is a meme that I came across. So no offense to Windows or Mac OS users, but yeah, as Windows users, you might have you know, downloaded a lot of antivirus stuff to take care of the viruses and the malwares that's there in your system. But the Linux users, they don't have to take care of that. So Linux is open source. So that's where you can understand the power of open source and how it is changing for the better, and how it has this security feature that's absent in Windows users. So yeah, moving on. How is open source changing lives? So since you're already here, you must be already knowing that there is no judgment. There is no one to judge you, or based upon your expertise, based upon what you've been learning or what you want to learn. So this is like a free and open space where you can share your knowledge, and people irrespective of technical backgrounds are able to unite and make software and hardware better. Of course, I forgot to include that, but yeah, it's basically making the software industry a better place. So next thing is, of course, no one judges you. And the next is, web is more accessible because everyone is able to contribute to it and able to use it. So yeah, web is more accessible through open source. The next thing is, it's everywhere. Top 500 supercomputers run Linux. So if you guys already are not aware of it, the largest Atom collider, that's the Large Hadron Collider, LHC, also is controlled by Linux. So yeah, open source is changing lives, and it's basically, as an operating system, it's there, it's providing a secure way to, you know, run and scale systems. So this is like the quintessential stuff of the whole thing, like to summarize it all, like what are the opportunities that open source provides to you? So the first being internships and fellowships. So even I started off as an applicant to one of the programs that's called Rails Girls Summer of Code. So yeah, I was a part of it, and I didn't know anything. I didn't know anything about Git, you know, about open source, about how to get started and all of that. I was as confused as you guys are as students. So the thing is, the next thing that people have already highlighted in various experience sharing sessions that we had yesterday is the power of networking. So of course, how did I come to know about this? So it's very important to surround yourself with people who are willing to help you and are, you know, willing to help you and, you know, show you the path, pave the path for you. So yeah, I had very supportive seniors. I'm very lucky for that. And I'm pretty sure many of you might have this question, that how you came across such, you know, supportive seniors. It's because we had a tech community back in college. My college was CET Bhubaneswar, so we had a tech community called Zyra. So I'm still a part of it, and so that's where I came to know about opportunities, about the different various fields and where I can venture into. So I started with, so I have been a vagabond, like when I started. So when I started building personal projects, it was, first of all, it was Android. And then I moved on to building visualizations using Python, like, you know, normal pandas, NumPy and stuff. And then I moved on to, you know, normally contributing to open source. So back in 2018, when my journey in open source started, was with Hacktoberfest. So yeah, another reminder, Hacktoberfest is going on now. So it's like a cool way to get a t-shirt, of course, but not for the sake of it. But it will also help you, you know, understand how Git works, how communities work, and what, like, it has a lot to offer. And you can make a most out of it right from the very beginning taking part into small, you know, small open source programs like Hacktoberfest. So yeah, my starting point was Hacktoberfest, and there was no looking back after it. So the other internships and fellowships that's provided by open source is Outreachy, of course. It's an open source program for underrepresented groups in tech. So, and also GSOC, like everyone knows about it. So yeah, even Muskan highlighted it yesterday. And the next we have Rails Girl Summer of Code, but it's no longer happening right now because of some obvious reasons, and lots more. So you can just go around and have a look at these programs if you want to get started. And you know, so it's not the only place where you can get started. So again, one more thing is Google Summer of Code is for students, but Outreachy is not. So these are just a way to get started with open source, not the ultimate goal, I would say. But yeah, this surely helps you get some clarity around what open source is. And this is just a sneak peek into what open source can provide. So yeah, next thing is makes way for new ideas, eventually leading to startups. So yeah, I have seen many of my friends, have ideas and collaborate over a version control system called Git, and they, have their projects on GitHub. And also, most of the startup ideas that come up are from hackathons. So that is also a great way to start. And you know, keep your project up there, and you can also participate as maintainers, as mentors, and open source opportunities like GirlScript Summer of Code. We have a lot of other local opportunities as well, which is provided by university campus level communities. So the next thing is opportunity to be a mentor or maintainer and take the power of community forward. So this is something that is extensively taken care of by GitHub as well. If you're thinking that, you know, open source is free and you won't be able to make money out of it, so GitHub has you covered. It has this sponsor button that you might have already come across, that if you are willing to sponsor a particular person who is funding a particular project, giving all the time and energy it needs. So yeah, you can always sponsor and be their ray of hope. So yeah, that will help them a lot, since they will be able to commit more time into maintaining that open source project. That is obviously going to help you. And if it's a great project, it is going to help millions as well. The next thing is speak at conferences and events and meet like-minded people. So this is something that is like the perfect epitome of where I am right now. That is, I used to be really shy. I didn't used to speak that much. And everyone has a first time. So I also had a first time. So yeah, this surely paved the way for speaking at conferences and helped me get out of my own cocoon that I had built around me. So yeah, this helped me a lot. And the next thing is also developing soft skills due to these conferences and meeting with people. You get to know how people people talk. And the next thing is code of conduct, that when you mix with people all around, you have to be you have to use more inclusive terms. So yeah, that's where you come to know about all of these stuff that you don't come to know about if you don't attend conferences or you don't get to meet people. Next thing is learn best practices in coding efforts. You're going to learn a lot from maintainers, from high level developers from all around the globe. So I think that's the win-win. The next thing is GitBay and other platforms which provide single contribution and economic benefits. So yeah, if you're thinking that I don't have a job around open source is not going to help me, yeah, it can help you. There are a lot of platforms like GitPay. There are some others as well. I'm not able to name that currently, but yeah, there are a lot of other platforms that that pay you for a single contribution, a single bug that you wish to that you either tell that to them or raise an issue or even contribute to solving that. So I guess that's another thing that you can look into if you are looking to making a career out of open source. The next thing is bug bounty programs. I've never participated in it, but I have seen a lot of people over LinkedIn posting about how they received a certain amount after participating in bug bounty programs. So I think it's a win-win because you let the company or the particular organization know that they have a bug, and they come to know about the bug as well. And the next thing is obviously you're making software better, and obviously you're getting paid for it. So yeah, so that's like win-win all over. So Next thing is the quote that I want to share from Linus Torvalds. So he's the creator of Linux. So in real open source, you have the right to control your own destiny. I think that is something that's completely apt, and I totally agree to it. I totally second it. So yeah, if you guys want to have a look at it, I think it's the best way to start and get started with open source. The next thing is, as a beginner, you feel that how can I get that experience? So if you have something that's free, which can provide you that level of experience as an internship, so I think that's great. So that's where open source comes into play. So that's where I would like to recommend open source a lot, because that helps you, write code, learn from people who are writing world-class code, and not really world-class, not really the world-class code, but yeah, writing softwares that is solving a lot of problems in real life. I'm sweating all over. I'm so sorry. But yeah, the humidity in Bhubaneswar is really bad. So this is my expression after I learned about open source. And I think that this is still the best. And once I ventured into it, it's been 3 years and I'm not able to steer away from it. So yeah. So next thing is linked to open source internships and competitions. I think this is a very exhaustive list that I've come across on GitHub. That is by Tapaswini Pathak. So you can go around and have a look at the open source programs and get started with it. So even if you don't get through it, it's not a problem. You can always come across projects and integrate into the community and know more about opportunities from the people in the community as well. So it's not a hard and fast that if you don't get through these open source internships and competitions, you won't be able to do anything. Nothing of that sort. Don't be too hard on yourself. But yeah, this surely helps you gain that confidence and puts you in a better place than where you are currently. Like puts you in that learning path that you should be always grateful to, of course, when you venture into open source. So the timelines are also available here. You can go and have a look at it. So like which internship is happening at what time and when you need to apply and all of that. So we can just go and have a look at look there. So the next thing is, what can you contribute as a beginner? So the first thing is obviously code, but yeah, there are a lot of other things, plethora of other stuff that you can contribute to as an open source contributor. Next is writing tests, that is just testing whether some code is working properly or not. So if you're already familiar with the test-driven environment, there are some people who write tests and then write the code for that test. So that helps you gain some clarity around what feature or what bug you want to solve. So the next thing is obviously bug reports. People think that if I report an issue, that's not a contribution. But yeah, that is a contribution. Even GitHub calculates it as a contribution. You can try and open an issue and see. And the next thing is answering questions. Of course, if you know about a particular project, there is no hard and fast that even if you have not contributed to it, you can still go and answer the questions in the forums. The next thing is documentation and blog posts. So I saw Pavitra. So she has been a part of Google Season of Docs. So yeah, she has worked in documentation for with Wikipedia for a very long time. So kudos to that. And I can see her growing as well. So congratulations again, Pavitra. So if you want to talk about Google Season of Talks as well, she's the go-to person, let me tell you. And the next thing is graphics. Obviously, open source is not all about code. As engineers, we also need to know about design patterns, know about how a particular software should look like. So that's where graphics and design comes into play. So we have designers, we have graphic stuff for that. There are a lot of open source programs that have this thing about, they have this issue like, design a logo for us and all of that. Even Fedora has such issues. So you can go and have a look at that as well. The next thing is user interface and user experience. So that is UI UX. That's basically how a website or a particular app should look to you as a user. The next thing is volunteering and marketing in suitable platforms. So this helps you in developing that sense of community that you can get. It helps you provide opportunities, like give yourself that opportunity to volunteer and market yourself in suitable platforms like LinkedIn, and you can make a brand out of yourself. So yeah, this surely helps you in contributing to, like, the way you contribute to open source. That is something that open source gives back to you. So the next thing is organizing meetups and or conferences. So the next thing is if you are already gaining a lot of it out of it, so it should enable you and put you in a position where you can give back by organizing meetups, helping people know about such communities, and also attend and help around conferences, like volunteer around conferences. So the next thing is, how do you get started? I get asked about it a lot, so I decided to compile it and these slides. So the first thing is learning basics about open source platforms. That is, what is version control system, how issues work, how pull requests work, how you can create a pull request, how you can create an issue, how you can get started with, how can you just get started with a code base? How can you clone it? How can you look at that from your own editor and on a local environment? So that is where you start. So the next thing is find your passion, of course. So if you're interested in Python, you can go ahead with Python projects. If you're interested in JavaScript, you can go ahead with JavaScript projects. And this is like a plethora of other stuff, not really Python and JavaScript, but the others as well, like Rails, there is Ruby, and other lesser known languages that very few developers work upon, but there is a high demand for such developers. So I would surely say, find your passion and then give it a try. You can always explore and build personal projects around it, and you can always explore whether this is something that you want or you don't want. So the next thing is find a project associated with your passion. Yeah, so I'm interested in Python. So where do I get started? So you can just browse around Python projects on GitHub or Bitbucket or any other suitable platforms and get the knowledge about a project that you would be interested to contribute to, or that can be something that you're already using as an open source software. So the next thing is talk to volunteers and our project maintainers, of course. So this is something that open source gives to you. That is, you always get a chance to connect and network with, open source maintainers. That was another moment that I met Armin Vranesher and Travis Oliphant. Travis Oliphant being the creator of NumPy, and Armin Vranesher in 2017. He's the creator of Flask. So it was like something that I've been using, and you get to see them right in front of you delivering a keynote in PyCon. So that is what Python community provides as well. So yeah, that was a total win-win position. If you are able to connect with the creators of such great stuff that you're using from day to day. And next is find newcomer friendly issues. So there is a lot of labels that's available on GitHub that is up for grabs. There is low hanging fruit, there is first timer issue. So you come across a lot of such labels when you are trying to contribute to Hacktoberfest. So there is also a website that's called First Timers Hacktoberfest. If you want to have a look on about projects, you can learn about projects that you can get started with as a contributor, as a participant of Hacktoberfest. So next thing is, even if you're contributing to Hacktoberfest, I came across this issue very recently. So what happened is I saw some maintainers complaining that people are coming and spamming. So don't do that, please don't do that, because that is hurting the essence of open source community. So yeah, I know it's very important to show up. I know it's very important to get started, but don't just get started for the sake of getting started. Get started because you want to get started and you want to add value to that open source community. So yeah, pay attention to that. So the next thing is integrate into the community. Of course, you get a chance to contact and network with the community. So yeah, this helps you integrate and be a part of that community. So the next thing is pass it on. Of course, there is this rule that lifting others while you climb gives you a lot of mental satisfaction, because you're able to guide other people who were there, because you were there at their place at one point of time. So you're able to clarify certain stuff, demystify certain stuff. So that is really great experience as well. That is why I ventured into mentoring. So I guess if you guys are passionate about it, you should totally give it a try. So this is like the ladder that you might have come across like a multiple number of times, because this is from Google. So yeah, I got this from Shutterstock. So this is like the ladder. Like, you have to keep yourself motivated all during this time. So during this time of the pandemic, you are able to have a lot of time to yourself. So that is also a very good opportunity to get started with open source. That is, of course, you will get started to, I won't be able to do it, and then I can't do it. Then at certain point of time, you will have to be at it and show up and be have that belief in yourself that you'd be able to do it, and then ultimately you'll be able to do it. So that is like the thing that every developer will say, like be it a first-timer developer, be it an experienced developer, be it an intermediate developer, they all started at one point. So yeah, so it's very, very, very important to get started. So we have this physics thing as well, right? I've not been very good with physics, but yeah, the most power that one requires is one, while one is trying to get started, like the most amount of force that's required. So take that leap of faith, and you won't believe what you're capable of once you are doing it. So yeah, be at it and keep feeding your curiosity, and do that for yourself. So thanks a lot for lending your ears to me, and feel free to ask any questions in the chat. And this is my social media handle if you want to get in touch with me. So yeah, thanks a lot for lending your ears.
Thank you, Manasvini. That was like really inspiring.